girl. Daddy's gotta do some work, okay? Come on. Really?
What's going on, guys? I'm here with Noel, obviously. So I'm helping one of my boys with some of his business stuff, right? And he's a fellow photographer, and he's like, hey, how do I get proofing done with my clients, right? Now, proofing is something I've been doing for a while with between Google Drive and Lightroom and Dropbox and all these other different systems that allow proofing and image delivery. And I've currently fallen on Lightroom. And he wanted to know how to do it. So I was like, you know what? I think that'll make a good video. So here we are. In these next 7 to 8 minutes, I'm gonna show you exactly how I go from selecting the pictures in Lightroom to uploading to Lightroom Web, setting up for proofing, sending off to the client, and bringing the client selections back into Lightroom Classic. So let's get into it. So now that we're on our computer and we have Lightroom open, getting things into your proofing for clients or whoever you want to get it to is fairly simple. You see these over here? These are all collections that I have built in Lightroom Classic specifically for different people, different clients, different scenarios, what have you, right? So all you're really going to do is, let's just say I have, we can go up here. So this is an album cover I put together for one of my clients. Say I want to get this to her right now. All I'm really going to do is, since this is highlighted, make sure it is highlighted. You could just do that by clicking on it. We're going to run down here and you see this little plus button. It says new collection. We're going to click that and we're going to create our collection. Now we're going to name our collection whatever we want. I'll just put test collection for now. Collection. And it's gonna drop right into this collection in Lightroom Classic. Now it may take a little bit of time depending on your internet connection and your computer. But what's gonna happen is, if you are connected to the internet and you are synced right here, this will sync with Lightroom Mobile. Not Lightroom Mobile. This will sync with the Lightroom Web. And one thing you can do to ensure that it is gonna sync with Lightroom Web is, you see we're down here at test collection. You wanna make sure it's click on sync with Lightroom, and you'll get this notification right here saying it's syncing with Lightroom, and bam, this little icon, sync with Lightroom pending. This lets me know, and see right here, it's syncing. So that's how we know that everything is gonna sync. Now, you can either go directly to your Lightroom account on the, just by typing it in, lightroom.adobe.com, XYZ, or we can go here and view to Lightroom links and view on the web. Now, once you drop into your Lightroom Web, it's gonna have everything you uploaded in chronological order. And as you can see, it hasn't quite caught up to our new test collection yet, which will always fall down in an uncategorized collection, an uncategorized album over here. Let's see, we have test collection, so that should be down here. And actually, boom, here it is. It's right here. Test collection, we have our big mad folder, our big mad picture. Boom, this can be sent to the client. We can go ahead and set this for download right now. So let's see, when we go to share an invite, click settings and allow downloads and export. This will allow whoever you send the link to download the images in a JPEG format. Now, what we wanna do is actually set this up for proofing. So what we're gonna do is click here, these little two checkboxes. Boom, we have right here, enable proofing to view selected photos and comments here. That's our lead feedback. We click this little icon again. Remember, this was our settings and everything. And we're going to click enable proofing. Now, this is going to be a different link that you actually send versus the original link that you would send your clients. This will be specifically your proofing link. And again, this is different from the actual link you would send them to download images. So generally what I do is I have a proofing folder, and then I will have a actual finals folder, a folder with all the final images. And just to kind of give you an example of what the proofing looks like, I'm gonna take you to another client's images that I'm currently working on. And I'm gonna click this little button again to see all the images that they picked. Now, boom, we have all the images that they picked right here, ready to go. It lets me know, like, okay, these are the ones that they liked. Now you're asking, okay, how do I get this back into Lightroom so I know which images to edit? What you're gonna do is you're gonna click this arrow here where it says create album. You can either select all of them and create a separate album and then resync that with Lightroom, but I'm gonna teach you a easier way. You're gonna click this and click flag all. And you wanna flag all your assets. And what this will do is when you go back to Lightroom Classic, let's look for that Snarkies folder. Here we go, Snarkies proofing. Once it syncs, you can go to click over here on filters and flagged. And now all the photos that you have now flagged in Lightroom Web have now been flagged here in Lightroom Classic. Also, anytime they leave a like or a comment, say they want a very specific edit, this little yellow comment icon down here, or if you've already clicked on it, it would be gray, but this little thing right here, that lets you know that they've left a like or a comment on it. And then obviously from there, you can right click, and then edit in Photoshop. And then you can just do everything else that way. And that is how you enable proofing for clients in Lightroom.
I love, Noel, I love you too. I love you too, Noel. Hey. Look, okay. Yes. You could be in my video. All right, you could be in my video. Just calm down. Calm down.